We're going to start with translational motion. And the first thing we'll do is cover one-dimensional motion. So things just moving in a simple straight line. We won't do anything with two dimensions or anything yet. After covering one-dimensional motion, we'll move to two-dimensional motion. And once we understand how things move in more than one dimension, we'll be able to start talking about forces and what happens to things when we start pushing or pulling on them and see how they react. The first thing we're going to do is really put ourselves in the shoes of somebody who is first coming up with all of these ideas in the first place. You're walking around, or you're sitting at your own desk right now, and you see an object in front of you. And we're going to ask a question about a simple object like this one. You just have it, and you do something, and why did that happen? And you really have to wonder. You look at the things in front of you, again, your books or your computer, and you ask, why is it doing the things that it's doing? And we're going to really ask two questions. First, when something does what this apple just did, and it does something, you can ask, what are the laws that govern how that object moved and behaved, and why did it do that? But secondly, and very key and crucial to physics, and the idea of developing physics, is using the ideas of what I just saw happen and measuring what I just saw happen. Could I somehow predict how it will move and behave in the future if I know what happened right now? Using these two questions, we can really motivate a few things we can measure about a simple object like the apple I just showed you. So first, let's look at this apple that we have on the screen here. And let's ask, what things could we ask about this apple? What things could I ask you? The first thing is, where is it? We can ask, where is our object? What we do to define a position of an object is first we pick an origin, some place to call home, really, a zero point. And then to define a position, we say, how far is the apple from my origin? You can see on this graph here, we've defined an origin that has a zero point on it. And then we measure the position of the apple, which we call x, as how far in meters, which will be our units, is the apple from the origin. In this case, if I asked you where this apple is, you could look at it and say, well, it looks like it's about 1 meter from our origin, and that would be the position of this apple. The units that we use to measure these positions are meters, like I said, and the abbreviation for this unit of meters will be m. So if you see that m, it's not minutes or anything else, it's the actual meters telling you where your object is. Secondly, I could ask you, is this object moving? So as we saw when I let go of the apple, it just suddenly started to fall. We can ask a number of things about this position, which we are going to call v for the motion of the object, which stands for velocity. And this velocity is measuring for us how the position of the object is changing as time goes on. So it's meters per second. How many meters is the object moving every second in time? The units for velocity are meters per second, because we're measuring how many meters per second it's moving. And so when you see this m-s, that's really m divided by s, or meters per second, how many meters in a given second. If this apple is moving off to the right, and every second it goes from 1 meter, and then it's at 2 meters, and then at 3 meters, and so on, I could ask you if every interval is in fact 1 second interval, and it's moving 1 meter in each second interval, what is the velocity of this apple? And you would say the velocity is, as you would expect, 1 meter every second. So we would say simply the velocity of this apple is 1 meter every second. But then, not only can the position be changing, and we give that a name, velocity, but the velocity itself can also be changing. And so we call this change the acceleration. Is this apple accelerating? If it were, it would look something more like this, where the apple is actually moving, but it's not moving the same amount of distance in every second. So maybe in the first second, it only goes 0.5 meters, but then in the next second, it goes a full meter. And then in the next second after that, it goes a full 1.5 meters. So you can see it's doing what we call speeding up. It's gaining speed. And we measure this using acceleration. The acceleration of this object we call a. The units, sort of as you'd expect following the trend, are meters per second per second. In other words, how many meters per second is this object changing its velocity every second? And so the units abbreviated are meters per second squared, because those two units of seconds will come together and just say seconds squared. If I looked at this object, or asked you to look at this object and measure, how is the velocity of this object changing? You can see that because it's going 0.5 meters and then 1 meter and then 1.5 meters as the seconds go on, its velocity is changing by 0.5 meters per second every second. So in other words, the acceleration is measuring how the velocity is changing. while the velocity is measuring how the position is changing. And that is the key way to understand what you're seeing on this graph, which is that each variable is measuring how the variable before it is changing. And that gives it those units of seconds in the denominator.